Now I'm going to untwist the bag to see what happens. Okay, are you ready? One, two, three. Hey everyone, it's me, Atom. That's spelled A-T-O-M, like the tiniest building blocks in the universe. Welcome to my lab, where steam matters. As a matter of fact, I was going to drink my ice water when I got a knock on the door. It was my good friend Kelvin. He came over for a visit and I forgot all about my ice water. But that's okay, I can drink it now. Hey, wait a second. My ice is gone! But the water level hasn't changed. That doesn't make any sense. If the ice melted, shouldn't the water level go up? But it didn't. So where did the ice go? This calls for an investigation. Did the ice shrink? Nope, I don't see the tiniest bit in there. Did it escape? Can you help me look for ice footprints? Nope, I don't see any ice footprints anywhere. Did it go up in the sky? Nope, I don't see any there either. Wait a second, maybe the ice didn't disappear. Maybe it just changed. Let's start with what we already know. Ice is made of water, right? But it looks different. Why? Because of something called matter. Matter is just a fancy word for anything that takes up space. And matter comes in three main types: solids, liquids, and gases. Ice is a solid, water is a liquid, and the air we breathe is a gas. Can you take a deep breath with me? Let's try it. Wow, did you feel all that air filling up your lungs? Me too! But what makes the states of matter different? And why does my ice disappear when it melts? Wait, what? Fun fact! Did you know that glass isn't exactly a solid or a liquid? Scientists call it an amorphous solid because its particles aren't arranged like normal solids, but they don't flow like a liquid either. Some old windows actually have thicker glass at the bottom because the glass slowly moves down over time. If the ice really changed into water, then maybe the water level didn't rise because it was already taking up space in the glass and it just changed from ice into water. But how? Okay, a hypothesis is just a smart guess that we can test. So, my guess is maybe the ice didn't actually add any extra water when it melted. Maybe it was already taking up space. Only one way to find out. Let's experiment. Okay, the water level is reading at about 200 milliliters. Let's drop a rock in to see if the water level goes up. Here we go. One, two, three. Wow, look at that. It did go up. That means the rock is pushing all the water out of the way. Now, let's try to drop an ice cube in and see if the water level goes up. Here it goes. Look at that, it floated. Ooh, look, the water level did go up. So that means it is pushing the water out of the way. Now, let's let it melt to see whether or not the water level changes. And if it doesn't, then that would prove that the water level didn't change when the ice melted. Okay, so before we drop the ice cube in the water level was just below 200 milliliters. But when we drop the ice in, the water level rose to 200 milliliters exactly. And now that the ice is completely melted, it has stayed at 200 milliliters exactly. So that means that the ice that we dropped in changed into water and it is still taking up the same amount of space as it was before. Wait, what? Fun fact, did you know that water displacement helped Archimedes figure out how to measure the volume of massive objects, and it led to his discovery of buoyancy? Buoyancy is why some things float and why some things sink. He even shouted, "Eureka!" when he figured it out. That's science for ya. Okay, but why does ice even stay solid? And why does water stay liquid? And why does steam float away? Let's find out by freezing a little bit of this water. I'm gonna add a little bit of this water to this beaker, and I'm going to do, let's do about 60 milliliters. That's a little too much. That's pretty close to 60 milliliters. We're going to freeze it and see what happens. Whoa, it expanded. The ice is actually bigger than the water was before. See, I had filled the beaker up to exactly 60 milliliters. Now it's slightly above 60 milliliters. That means something is happening inside the ice that makes it take up more space. Okay, so we saw that solids like ice can turn into liquids when they melt. And we learned that liquids like water can turn into solids when they freeze. But what about gases? Oh, that reminds me. One time I left a glass of water outside in the summer, and when I came back for it, the water was completely gone. Where did it go? Did someone drink it? Or did it turn into a gas and float away? I have an idea. Let's make our own gas and see what happens. I'm going to pour about 50 milliliters of vinegar into this zippable bag. I know, let's add some food coloring to make it fun. Couple of drops should do. Mix it around. Okay, now I'm going to twist the bag to help contain the vinegar. Next, I'm going to open up the mouth of the bag, and we're going to pour in about 50 milliliters of baking soda straight into the top. That's about right, right there. Now I'm going to seal the zip tie on the bag, just like so. Now I'm going to untwist the bag to see what happens. Okay, are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Whoa, look at it go. Look, it's expanding. Ooh, it may pop. Nope, it didn't pop, but look how much bigger the bag got. That's because the vinegar reacted with the baking soda to create carbon dioxide, and it filled up the bag. And because a gas like carbon dioxide is lighter than air, it wants to float up out of the bag and go everywhere. Isn't that cool? Wait, what? Fun fact. The bubbles that's in your soda are the same gas that's inflating the plastic bag, carbon dioxide. That's why soda fizzes when you open it. And guess what? If you shake a soda before you open it, the bubbles escape too fast, just like in the plastic bag, and it explodes. But let's not try that right now. Okay, we figured out that ice, water, and air are all made of the same thing, matter. But why do they act so differently? Imagine these glass beads are tiny people, like super tiny people. These are molecules. Everything around us is made up of molecules, even you and me. In a solid, the molecules hold hands really tight, like two best friends who don't want to let go. That's why solids stay the same shape. Ice stays ice because the molecules are hugging each other so close. In a liquid, the molecules still hold hands, but they're more relaxed. They can move and slide past each other. Like when you wiggle through a crowd, That's why water can pour and take the shape of a cup. But in a gas, the molecules don't hold hands at all. They zoom all around, everywhere, like kids running wild at recess. That's why air fills up a whole room and steam floats away. Wait, what? Fun fact! Did you know that if you heat something up enough, it can turn into a fourth state of matter called plasma? That's what stars are made of, even our sun. So, when we froze the water, we made the molecules grab onto each other tightly, turning it into ice. And when we let the ice melt, the molecules relax and turn back into liquid water. That's why solids, liquids, and gases change. It's all about temperature. Mystery solved. Science wins again. Okay, so now we know solids, liquids, and gases are different because of how their particles move. And we learned that heat and cold can change their states. Science is amazing. Now, it's your turn. Try these experiments at home with an adult and see what you can discover. Phew, that science experiment really made me thirsty. Hey, I got a great idea. Nice cold ice water. Now that hits the spot. See you next time on Adam's Lab. Bye-bye.